Dusk of 28th August 2017, that is today, we have all gathered here for a very momentous and extremely joyous occasion. This is to celebrate the 75th birthday of Padma Bhushan Dr. R.S. Baroda, Chairman TAS, President ISPGR, and co-chair of highly acclaimed International Agro Biodiversity Congress 2016. On behalf of organizing committee and on my personal behalf, I welcome you all to the Diamond Jubilee celebrations of Dr. R.S. Baroda's 75th birthday. A man beyond the realms of the ordinary. A man beyond the realms of the ordinary, a visionary beyond the visible. Dr. Baroda is the main architect of one of the world's largest and most modern national gene bank at NBPGR. A role model for all generations to come. This is one name which epitomizes hope, aspirations, honesty, commitment, exemplary vision, dynamic leadership, and human spirit. Many of us are witness that today in the afternoon of his 75th birthday, sir was busy chairing the brainstorming meeting on strategies for implementation of Delhi Declaration for Agro-Biodiversity Management in India. Such is the commitment and vision of Dr. Baroda, which all of us need to imbibe. Recipient of several national and international awards and recognitions, Dr. Baroda has received 15 DSc degrees from universities around the world. He's a unique blend of pragmatism and vision, and turning dreams into reality is his forte. Acknowledged internationally for his scientific leadership, he has brought together a diverse range of leaders and thinkers at a common platform and provided them a vision and focus beyond their own roles. Founder President of Global Forum on Agricultural Research, Executive Secretary of APARI for more than two decades, Chairman, the only Indian so far, as well as Vice Chairman of ICRISAT Governing Board, he has been on Board of Trusts, Committees and Advisory Council. I shall be falling short of words to describe his astounding contribution not only towards Indian agriculture, but also towards agro-biodiversity management in India by putting the country on the global map. I can just go on and on till words fail me. We are fortunate that today the occasion is being graced by none other than Guruon ke Guru Mahaguru, Padma Vibhushan Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, the nonagenarian who is chairman M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation, Chennai, and is also one of the 20 most influential Asians of the 20th century. A role model to emulate. He needs no more introduction. Many luminaries on the dais and many amongst the dignitaries in the hall, along with many still not so old like me, are blessed to have been associated with him professionally or personally, with a lingering memory to cherish upon. Today, when he's completing 75 illustrious years of his life, may I request you all to give a standing ovation to Dr. Baroda on his 75th birthday, truly the creator and preserver of this vast Indian agriculture and PGR. तालियों की गड़गड़ाहट इतनी ऊंची हो जितनी ऊंचाइयों पर डॉक्टर परोड़ा ने नार्स और इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर को पहुंचा दिया है. Now to welcome the dignitaries on the dais, may I request Dr. Pratibha and Ms. Shivani to welcome Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, Chairman MSSR. Party and General Secretary ISVGI. As the popular saying goes, the illustrious woman, she is none other than Mrs. Shashi Parora, who is right here with us. We are privileged to have you with us, ma'am. And
impressive massive National Agriculture Science Center complex located at Roomsa campus was built mainly due to his vision, initiative and dedication. He has made significant research contributions in the field of plant breeding and genetic resource management, which is evident from the release of 10 improved crop varieties at national level, 250 research papers in journals of repute, 10 books, and more than 25 proceedings of national and international conferences and expert consultations held in different parts of Asia Pacific, Europe, and Latin America. The International Crop Research Institute for Semi-Agricultural at Hyderabad and Agricultural Research Institute of Kazakhstan have named their gene banks after Dr. Baroda in recognition of his valuable contributions in the field of genetic resource management. In fact, he is often called a gene bank guru by his friends and admirers. Dr. Baroda has received several national and international awards and recognitions. Dr. Baroda has been conferred honorary doctorate of science by 50 academic institutions, including Ohio State University and Indian Agricultural Research Institute. He has been acknowledged internationally for his scientific leadership. He has served as founding president of the Global Forum on Agricultural Research, GAFAR, from 1988 to 2001. He also served for more than two decades as Executive Secretary of Asia Pacific Association of Agricultural Research Institutions, ABARI, a well-known regional forum fostered by him to strengthen regional research collaboration. Till recently, Dr. Baroda worked for the overall benefit of farmers as Chairman of Farmers Commission of Haryana, Chairman of Working Group on Agriculture, and member of Rajasthan Planning Board. He was mainly responsible for the drafting and release of state agriculture policies, both in Haryana and Rajasthan. He has spearheaded the organization of a number of symposia, conferences, and seminars to promote the cause of science nationally, regionally, and globally. At regional level, in his capacity as Executive Secretary of ABARI, he conceptualized and organized more than 25 regional expert consultations on highly thematic issues in different parts of Asia Pacific. To promote science and scientific fraternity, Dr. Baroda has been associated with several national scientific societies. He has been president of many, like Indian Society of Genetics and Plant Breeding, Oil Seeds Research, Forage Research, Desert Technology, Allopathy, Plant Biochemistry and Biotechnology, Plant Physiology, Agricultural Statistics, Orchid and Microbiologists. He started the Indian Society of Plant Genetic Resources in 1987 and is presently providing able leadership as its president. Behind every successful man stands a very supportive family. So is the case with Dr. Baroda. He has been lucky to have his graceful wife, Shashi Baroda, as a proverbial pillar of strength all through. She worked as a soil microbiologist at Chaudhary Charan Singh Haryana Agriculture University for 37 years. Post-retirement, she is happy and contented in her new role as a full-time homemaker and enjoying her health, spiritual and charity pursuits. His firstborn, Anju, is as vivacious and hardworking as him, and his best little children, Vikram and Nishi. His second born, Somil, as dedicated and daring as him, is married to Victor and has a son, Mona, and a daughter, Yashi. His youngest child, Prashant, is as focused and intelligent as him. He is married to charming Shipra, and his best two daughters, Ariana and Amara. Presently, Dr. Baroda is the chairman of Trust for Advancement of Agricultural Science at New Delhi, which aims to link science with society. He has taken on the mantle to promote growth and advancement of agriculture through scientific interactions and partnerships.
So you'll all agree with me that Dr. Baroda's name should definitely be written in the history of Indian agricultural sciences. He shows no sign of slowing down. Achha, it is still there. Okay.
My motto in life has been to serve this society in the human face and create a required infrastructure for colleagues to perform to their best effort. My message to the youth is to embrace agriculture as their profession, to serve the society and also empower farmers for better living.
Friends, well-wishers and family members join together in wishing a very happy 75th birthday to Dr. R.S. Baroda. May he have a long, healthy and prosperous life and continue to remain a torchbearer for achieving highly sustainable, evergreen revolution in India and continue serving the global farming community with a human face.
So again, you'll all agree with me, at this young age of 75, Dr. Baroda still shows no signs of slowing down in his effective and innovative agriculture R&D advocacy and leadership. This is an inspiration for all of us. I'm very happy to announce that we now have the release of a book entitled A Visionary Extraordinaire, Dr. R.S. Baroda, a commemorative volume on his 75th birthday. May I request Professor V.L. Chopra, Chancellor, Central University of Kerala, to get it released from Dr. Swaminathan. May I request the editors of this commemorative volume to also please come on the dais. Dr. R.K. Tyag.
The editors of this volume, please. Dr. R.K. Tyag is already on the dais. Ms. Sonal D'Souza, Biology International.
And myself.
So I'd just like to read a few lines. The book is a compilation of messages, memories and wishes from friends, colleagues and relatives of Dr. Baroda to commemorate this glorious history. Believe me, this memoir reads like a story with vivid portrayal of different facets of Dr. Baroda's personality. The contributors, more than 200 from across the globe, it has woven together the poetry of his life. Importantly, it brings out the enormous wealth of love and affection that he has garnered during his journey of life by relating to a multitude of people from various backgrounds. So I'm also going to be there.
Dr. Raj Parodam and Dr. Shashi Parodam, members of the Paroda family, my distinguished colleagues on the podium and also in the audience. I have a little problem with my legs, so I'm not standing up, so excuse me. And I've also restricted my travel, but today is one day which I would not like to miss. I have known Dr. Parodha for over 50 years, and all 50 years we've been uniformly, every day, you know, in life, you count the number of years of your life, but it's not the number of years which are important, but what you have done with those years. And that is where I think Dr. Parodha, every year, whether it was in India, whether it was in FAO, whether it was in CGIR, Middle East, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, all those places, wherever he has gone, he has left his footprints on the sands of time. Very few people do it. Such consistent performance from the student days till today. Now the task, the establishment of the trust, the establishment of so many new. Apari was mentioned in the film. Apari is a unique organization which he has built up. Left a number of institutions. I won't be sitting here, all of you, all of us will not be sitting here, but for him. This building was built by him. All this whole NAA. Such a complex being needed, but he converted the vision into action. That's one of the great, great features of Dr. Parodha. He's not content with statements, not content with the vision, but the vision should become a reality. And therefore, today we are celebrating the life and work of a very great person, a great Indian, one of the greatest Indians of our time. And we are proud of what you have done, Raj. And also Shashi was mentioned as one who gave all the help to ensure that he was able to do it. I can go on talking because I said I have known him for over 50 years. There are many things to narrate. But I would say that consistently is the creation of new institutions, whether it is the NBPGR, the new institutions which he has built, and also the new organizations, new societies, national, international, and above all, the organization of scientific meetings and symposia on relevant issues. The latest example was the International Congress on Agrobiodiversity. For the first time, an international congress was held on agrobiodiversity. He is the one who awakened the people that we won't be alive today, we won't be eating what we eat, but for agrobiodiversity. So in any many areas, as I said, wherever he has gone, he has left his footprints, and I want to join everyone here. I came all the way. I was not planning to come today to Delhi, but when I received the invitation about his birthday, I thought this is one occasion I will not like to miss because of my great respect and the opportunity to say a few words about you. I wish you all the best, the whole family, and I wish you many more years. As I said, the years are meaningful only if they lead to some productive work, and that he will continue. And I want to wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir, for your wishes and blessings. May I now request Professor V.L. Chopra to share his thoughts on this occasion.
Professor Swaminathan, Dr. Parodha, dignitaries on the dais, many more in the audience. Shashiji, I'm told that Purada children are here. I don't know whether they recognize me. I will have to be helped and identify them because I have known them as small children. Now they are grown up. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'll come and see you later. I feel extremely lucky to be able to participate in this very impressive gathering to wish Dr. Purada many happy returns of the day on his 75th birthday. A great deal has been said about Dr. R.S. Purada already. I don't want to recapitulate it. I have known from close quarters his commitment and the hard work that has resulted into the many achievements which have been listed both through spoken word and through the documentation. His commitment and hard work is often cited as an example. Many things that he has achieved, some listed, some already not listed, are because he doesn't take up a job just to finish it. He's interested in seeing that the outcomes of it are meaningful and worth their record in their own right. I will not attempt to list the many glorious achievements that are to the credit of Dr. Purada. But I would like to recall many moments of personal happiness that I've shared with him and his family. Dr. Purada is known to be a tough, hard taskmaster. I know that he is that, but he is much more than that. I fondly recall the lighter moments that we have shared with Dr. Purada, which included sharing frugal meal in the first floor of the Nuclear Research Laboratory,